I'm super excited about this package from Shaun of SNP Reflash in Canada. He offers reflashed OEM ECUs for 2nd-gen TCs as well as a couple other Toyotas. This particular one is tuned for 93 octane, but can run on 91 minimum. We can see this is marked with SNP for Gen 2 and 2.5 manual transmission TCs. This is actually from a 2011 to 2013. Shaun has tuned both the 2 and 2.5 ECUs and said he can get more power out of this one. Make sure you've been running 93 octane in your tank before installing one of these ECUs. It's recommended to clean the MAF sensor before installing, especially since the 2011 to 13 ECU idle is a little finicky when coming to a stop, but it generally sorts itself out after some driving. All I need to do is unclip the harness and remove the two bolts to free the sensor. I highly recommend using CRC MAF sensor cleaner and nothing else. Using the straw attachment, you want to spray the two wires inside here. You want to get them really good, and make sure you don't touch them or you may damage the sensor. You're going to want to get the wire on the side as well. Aside from a clean sensor, you'll also want to have a clean air filter. Since I have a K&N one, I use their cleaning kit, but I just cleaned mine last week so I can skip this part. The actual process of removing and installing the ECU is documented in my ECU swap and immobilizer reset video, which I have linked in the video description. Just follow it until you get to the part where you turn on the car with the paperclip inserted into the OBD2 port and then return to this video. With the new ECU installed, now I just need to wait 30 minutes for the immobilizer to be reset to my transponder. Now to turn the car off and pull out the paperclip. Shaun said I should leave the car off for 15 seconds and then turn it on, but don't start it. I'll put all these steps in the video description below for easy reference. Now to turn the car on and wait 30 seconds. Okay, let's start her up. Wow, it always stalls out on me on my first attempt. I'll have to remember this trick in the future. If your car doesn't start the first time, it should start on the second try. Now we want to let it sit for a few minutes to relearn idle. I'll give it about 5. Now to turn the engine off, and start her back up again, but this time with the AC on. I'll let it idle for another 5 minutes. Idle should be good, so now to turn it off and back on one last time, and then go for a test drive. Shaun recommends doing this with traction control turned off. The 2011 to 13 ECU takes some time to adapt and learn, so I was recommended to drive casually for the first 5 to 10 miles before getting into the higher RPMs. Once I'm ready, Shaun said to do a pull to 4.5k, then another to 5k, then 1 to 6k, then finally 1 to red line. The red line on my ECU has been raised to 6800 RPMs. After about 3 to 4 pulls to redline, the car should be adapted, and after a full drive cycle, everything should be completely learned. I'm very happy with the new ECU. Now, I have the original Orange Fires Tuning version 3 handheld tuner 93 octane map on the car before, and this definitely makes more power than that. I can just tell from driving. I've got more power in the low, mid, and upper RPM range. Accelerating is better. Even just stop and go traffic in the city is much better. This is actually the third ECU related review that I've done. The first one being the now completely discontinued and unsupported Orange Fires version 3 handheld tuner, which let you take pre-made tunes and flash them onto your ECU. That was later replaced with the VF tuner that lets you program the ECU yourself. The only downside is that there are no existing tunes for that. You have to find someone that will share a tune with you, or program it yourself, or bring it to a shop. Ugh, it started to rain. Alright, I'm going to go ahead and answer a question that I know people are going to ask me. Am I going to get the car dynoed now that I have this new ECU? And unfortunately, the answer is no, or at least not right now. This ECU is actually Plan B. Plan A was to bring my car to Agile Automotive and have them professionally dyno tune it there, but I've had too many expenses come up, too many emergencies to handle, so I needed to find a less expensive means of getting some more power out of my car, and that's why I ended up checking out Shaun, because I've seen a bunch of posts from people online here and there talking about his reflashed ECUs, and lots of good reviews. In fact, after I posted up a picture about me testing out his ECU, I saw a lot of people that actually have his reflashed ECU, and they had nothing but good things to say. I hope this helps you out if you are looking for a way to get some more power out of your TC. Before I finish up the video, I will say I took one of my spare ECUs, because I have a few of them at home, and I popped swapped it back in so I could drive around stock, and then I threw this one afterwards. And I think that if you have a stock ECU and you get one of these reflashed ones, you're going to be very pleasantly surprised. I'll include information in the video description below on how to order one of these ECUs. Unfortunately, this is only available for manual transmissions, but Shaun said that he's going to be trying to support automatic TCs later this year. When that happens, and if one of the local automatic TC owners picks up that ECU, which probably means I'm going to be installing it for them, then I'll do a review on it just so you know it exists. But of course, you'll have to be subscribed to my channel to know when that happens. So if you haven't hit subscribe to my channel yet, please do so now. And as always, thank you for watching.